मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस ऑन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स पार्ट 5। क्वेश्चन नंबर 41। सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट एज पर चार्लेस लॉ। ऑप्शन ए पीवी इक्वल कांस्टेंट इफ टी इज केप्ट कांस्टेंट। ऑप्शन बी वी बाय टी इक्वल कांस्टेंट इफ पी इज केप्ट कांस्टेंट। ऑप्शन सी P by V equal constant if T is kept constant. Option D, T by P equal constant if T is kept constant. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is V by T equal constant if P is kept constant. That means volume is directly proportional to temperature when pressure is kept constant. Question number 42. The area under PV diagram of any thermodynamic process represents. Option A, heat rejection. Option B, heat absorption. Option C, work done. Option D, heat supplied. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is work done. Let us see the explanation. The area under PV diagram represents work done by gas in a thermodynamic process. Area under temperature entropy graph represents heat supplied to the thermodynamic process. Question number 43. Calorific values of gaseous fuels is determined by option A, bomb calorimeter. Option B, Junkers calorimeter. Option C, separating calorimeter. Option D, throttling calorimeter. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is Junkers calorimeter. Let us see the explanation. The calorific value of gas can be determined using Junkers calorimeter. It is a flow device mainly used to determine the heat of combustion and the calorific value of gaseous fuels. Question number 44. Otto cycle is also known as option A, constant pressure cycle. Option B, constant volume cycle. Option C, constant temperature cycle. Option D, constant temperature and pressure cycle. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is Otto cycle is also known as constant volume cycle. You can also see the PV diagram. Here 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. Question number 45. If the dryness fraction of steam is less than 1, then the steam is called as option A, dry steam. Option B, superheated steam. Option C, wet steam. Option D, both 1 and 2. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is wet steam. If the dryness fraction of steam is less than 1, then the steam is called wet steam. Let's see the explanation. We know the formula for dryness fraction of steam, that is, it is the ratio of vapor mass to the liquid summation of liquid mass and vapor mass. When dryness fraction of steam is less than 1, the steam is called wet steam. When dryness fraction of steam is equal to 1, the steam is called dry steam. Question number 46. The COP of a refrigerator working on the reversed Carnot cycle is: option A, T2 by T1 minus T2. Option B, T1 minus T2 by T2. Option C, T1 by T1 minus T2. Option D, T2 by T1 plus T2. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is T2 by T1 minus T2. Let us see the explanation. Let us assume T1 is the highest absolute temperature, T2 is the lowest absolute temperature. The COP of a refrigerator working on the reversed Carnot cycle is equal to lowest absolute temperature by highest absolute temperature minus lowest absolute temperature. That means COP of a refrigerator working on the reverse Carnot cycle is equal to T2 by T1 minus T2. So the answer is option A. Question number 47. A Carnot engine working between 600 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin produces 200 kilojoule of work. The heat supplied is: option A, 200 kilojoule. Option B, 400 kilojoule. Option C, 2000 kilojoule. Option D, 400 joule. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is 400 kilojoule. Let us see the explanation. T1 equals 600 Kelvin, T2 equals 300 Kelvin. The given work is 200 kilojoule. We know the formula for efficiency of Carnot engine, that is, efficiency equal to 1 minus T2 by T1 equal to work by heat supplied. Work by heat supplied equal to 1 minus T2 means 300 by T1 600. Q equal to W by 1 minus 300 by 600. That equal to, now substitute the work in this equation. Work is 200 kilojoule, 200 by 1 minus 1 by 2. Now simplify this one. We get Q equal to 400 kilojoule. So the answer is option B, 400 kilojoule. Question number 48. Kelvin Planck's law deals with the dash. Option A, conservation of heat. Option B, conservation of work. Option C, conservation of heat into work. Option D, conservation of work into heat. Let us count and start. Time up. The answer is Kelvin Planck's law deals with the conservation of heat into work. Let us see the explanation. Kelvin Planck stated that it is impossible to develop a cyclically operating device. The sole effect of which is to absorb energy in the form of heat from a single thermal reservoir and to deliver an equivalent amount of work. So the answer is option C, conversion of heat into work. Question number 49. Throttling, that means Joule-Thomson effect process, is a constant dash process. Option A, enthalpy. Option B, entropy. Option C, pressure. Option D, none of these. Let us countdown start. Time up. The answer is enthalpy. Throttling process is a constant enthalpy process. Question number 50. The point at which all three phases, that means solid, liquid and gas phases, coexist is known as the option A, freezing point. Option B, boiling point. Option C, triple point. Option D, none of these. Let us countdown start. Time up. The answer is triple point. The point at which all three phases like solid, liquid and gas phases coexist is known as the triple point. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.